More frustrating. Drawn out way too fucking much. Wasted potential. Fucking stop.
Find out what else we had to say about this month's movie Superfast in this episode of Bottom of the Barrel. Welcome back to the show where you guys find the worst movies available on Netflix for us to watch so that we can share the experience with you. I'm Tony Wade.
And I'm Ross. Thanks to Danielle Jenkins, we watched the movie Superfast, starring actors that are to real acting what Big Fizz Cola is to Pepsi.
She's not gonna have a lot of lines or a lot to do, but she's smoking hot, fun to look at.
Yep. Actors whose biggest contribution to acting is to look like the actual stars of actual movies that you actually saw.
And then, just in case there's any confusion, they pull an even better move.
Let's name the character after the actor that they look like. Lucas White, Vin, Jordana, Michelle, Detective Johnson.
Brilliant!
You know what this movie does get right though? Which so many comedies get totally wrong. They realize that the key to humor isn't in subtlety.
It's clinging to a single joke, like it's a scrap of wood in the North Atlantic, and you're Leonardo DiCaprio trying to get laid one more time. So what they do in this brilliant comedy is treat the comedy like a horse. And they kill the horse. And then they kick it. And then they punch it.
And then they shoot it.
And then they give it to people's elbow.
And then they yell at it.
Just to change things up.
And then they beat it.
They beat the dead horse.
Subtlety 101. And when it's all done, they got it.
Pure comedy gold.
Without all that f***ing fussy stuff like new content or writing or new jokes. Here's an example.
Popo, roll out!
Popo? You know, 5-0. Pigs, bacon, Barney. The heat, the law, the fuzz, the man.
Come on, just keep
the boys in blue. The thin blue line. Johnny Law, Smokey, Gumshoe, Flatfoot. Oh man, haven't you ever seen an episode of CSI or NCIS or
anything? Yeah, we got it.
So many jokes drawn out way too f***ing much.
This f***ing joke is one of the most painfully long 40 seconds of my entire f***ing life.
Rock-a-bye baby on the treetop. When the wind blows, the cradle will rock. When the bow breaks, the cradle will fall, and down will come baby.
Another brilliant move? Physical comedy. The movie's attempts to tap into the magic that made timeless comedies like the Three Stooges classic kind of makes you wonder, where has all the slapstick gone?
Tony, got your... Oh, jeez. Oh, you're filming. I'm sorry.
You just don't see it. Well, the directors of this movie apparently felt the same imbalance in the force.
So they carefully and subtly placed physical gags throughout the whole film.
But you have to pay attention.
If you blink, you'll miss them.
Then three.
You okay?
Or you might not. Similarly, I really appreciate how they don't leave anything for the audience to figure out on their own.
I mean, how many times have you been watching a movie when something funny happens, but you're not really sure that something funny happened?
And you just need someone to tell you.
Son of a bitch. Lock my keys in the car again.
Oh, that's what happened when he got out of his car with his keys still in the car, but then he went back to the car and tried to open his door, but his keys were on the seat because he'd locked them in there. I totally missed that.
That! Is comedy. Surprisingly though, there were some jokes and moments that actually went over pretty well. I kind of found myself laughing at something and being like, stop that shit! You're supposed to hate this movie! Moments like these.
Son of a bitch!
Fine. You can forget about coming over tonight and watching the season finale of The Bachelor. You're no longer invited!
Okay, Tony, that was pretty funny! There's a funny one!
Still chilly. It's at 90 degrees.
Yeah, but yours is at 60.
Sí, pero es tu climate. My side is 60, your side is 90.
The climates are not separate. It's just one climate.
Do you see any invisible divider here?
Look, my hand passed through. Look,
Look cómo se mete la mano. Si ves cómo se pasa la mano, Combines.
I love this guy. Yeah, really. But it's moments like this that make the movie even more frustrating. There was just so much wasted potential here. It could have actually been good.
There were a few really funny moments.
And then there were a lot of jokes that could have worked if they just f***ing stopped.
When a man and a woman make love, sometimes there can be unintended consequences.
So if I were to rate this movie on a scale of 1 to 10, 1 being the movie Spaceballs and 10 being Scary Movie f***ing 22, I'm gonna give it a 5, you know? Because it kind of teeters on the line of kind of being almost a good spoof movie, but then it just had moments where it just fucking ruined it, you know what I mean? And it kind of just makes you wish that it just actually lived up to its potential, and it didn't. So yeah, 5 pretty much does it for me.
All right, so 1 to 10, yeah, I get that. I mean, it is a spoof movie, and it does its best. Relative to all other spoof movies like it, I'm gonna give it a 4.5. It does well. It's got funny moments. I think it's all De La Soul. That actor just carries the entire comedy for me, as well as the rock actor. 4.5. It comes damn close to being a decent movie, but it's still pretty shitty.
Anyways, guys, thanks for watching.
Spread the word!
Share the video!
Subscribe to the channel so you can get updates on all the new content.
And don't forget to leave suggestions in the comment section down below for what you want us to watch next.
And remember,
it's gotta be the worst of the worst.
Bottom of the barrel.
Because that's what we f***ing do!
Thanks for watching, everybody.